This is your host, Swapnil Bhartia, and today we have with us once again Bassam Tabara, the founder of Abound, a Seattle-based startup in the cloud computing space, and also a creator and active maintainer of two very known open source projects, Rook and Crossplane. And today we are going to talk about Crossplane, which has been promoted from CNCF Sandbox to incubation. Bassam, first of all, it's great to have you back on the show.
Thanks, Swapnil. Always a pleasure to be here.
What problem is Crossplane solving? How it's helping teams to better manage their infrastructure resources?
Definitely, yeah. So Crossplane is a universal control plane. So if you're not familiar with what control planes do, these are control plane actually is the piece that is able to serve and deploy and manage infrastructure, as well as connect it up to applications. If you're using any cloud provider today, you're probably using their control planes, their proprietary control planes. And you can think of Crossplane as a universal control plane that you can actually layer on top of other cloud infrastructure and use it to manage infrastructure and connect it to your applications across the board. So multi-cloud, hybrid cloud, and on-premise scenarios are all supported. It's based on Kubernetes, the Kubernetes control plane, which is exciting because it means that it's in, you're probably already familiar with it. You know how to kubectl apply and use Crossplane or use any of your favorite tool or the amazing projects in the CNCF landscape and ecosystem that are around us.
If you look at a lot of these projects which become part of CNCF, most of these projects are already being used in production. So when these projects move to Sandbox, it's already running somewhere, you know, in production. So what impact you saw when once the project moved to CNCF Sandboxing? How does it help? As I said, you know, that there is already a user base, but Sandboxing and moving a project to CNCF plays a very big role in adoption, in, you know, people have confidence in that project that they know is under a neutral body now. So talk about some of the, you know, impact or accomplishment that you saw ever since it moved into Sandbox.
Yeah, so let me tease that apart. There are two personas that are probably impacted by your question. So first, the end user community. The end user community obviously looks at the CNCF and CNCF projects as a potential place where they can, you know, figure out what to adopt next in their platform and in their deployment, in production deployments, right? And so by having Crossplane be part of the CNCF as a project, I think it raises its a profile in some ways and ensures that the end user community is considering it when they're looking at the modernization effort that they're embarking on. As for the end user community, obviously moving from Sandbox to incubation, the criteria there is all around adoption and production deployments, and Crossplane is obviously has a ton of production deployments right now, and in large companies to small companies, everybody's adopting Crossplane. So it's really nice to see from that perspective the the transition to incubation project, which just is a reflection of its adoption in the end user community. For the ecosystem, it's also important to have it as a CNCF project because it ensures that there's a neutral governing body around us that is, you know, where the IP is held, and it ensures that there's an open governance model that we follow in Crossplane. So vendors like AWS or Google or Azure or VMware, Red Hat, et cetera, can look at Crossplane and have been looking at Crossplane, working with us on it as something that they can adopt in their products or something that they can recommend to their customers without fearing, a single vendor, you know, controlling the project or other things that you see around, you know, projects that don't follow an open governance model. So both aspects are important to us, and this is why we as Upbound donated Crossplane to the CNCF about a year ago, and we're excited to see it kind of rise up the ranks in the CNCF, and we're excited about the next stage, which is graduation. hopefully early next year we'll start that process.
When you do move a project into a neutral foundation, you lose control over the project. You know, you do not have that much sway as you would have. Also, when it's an internal company project, you can move at your own pace based on your own customer feedback. When your project becomes part of a foundation, it slows down a bit, it becomes more stable. So how do you kind of balance? Because as you said, you are venture, you know, funded, so you have to kind of convince a lot of folks too. So, but open source is a win-win game. It's not a lose, you know, some game. So talk about what value do you see in contributing or donating a project into a foundation?
So the CNCF is actually fairly unique in its approach. The CNCF doesn't enforce or mandate that a project follows a certain governance structure. They let each project self-govern. We, as the Crossplane community, have chosen a governance model for Crossplane. It's actually one that follows the governance model that we had in Rook, and also the model that Kubernetes itself follows. And it's one that's designed to be inclusive. It's one that's designed so that anyone, any vendor, competitive or not, can be part of the community, can actually build on top of these projects and use them. Crossplane follows, like I said, the lead of Kubernetes, which is very, you know, widely adopted by vendors. And in fact, we have just applied for the conformance program, to start a conformance program around Crossplane in the CNCF. And there are a number of vendors that have plans now to be certified Crossplane providers, and as well as distributions of Crossplane. And that's something that, you know, ensures that the ecosystem is healthy, ensures that we are all working together on, you know, a project that can benefit the community and can be, you know, regardless of whether there are, you know, commercial competition or commercial ambitions around the project, that there's still benefit to the community and you know, to the industry as a whole.
Excellent. Thanks for explaining that. If you just go back to the incubation and sandboxing, can you share what are the criteria that a project has to meet before it moves from sandbox into incubation and ultimately graduation?
Yeah, so the criteria to incubation is primarily rooted in production deployments by the end user community. So the more end users that have adopt a project and adopt it in ways that actually are critical to what they are doing, in their journey towards cloud native and cloud in general, That's the criteria. Crossplane, you know, if you read the incubation proposal, there are tens of companies that have self, you know, nominated to be included there, and they've talked about their production deployments, and the technical oversight committee at the CNCF actually calls and interviews each of them, and it's a lengthy process to get to that. And so, you know, that's primarily the criteria around incubation. And then the graduation, I'd say the primary criteria is obviously increased production deployments and from the end user community, but also diversity of contributors and maintainers around the project. So I remember when we took Rook to graduation, that was a pretty important criteria to get it there, because you had to show that, you know, not only is it being adopted in the end user community, but the vendor community was actually adopting it and using it, and that it was, and they were contributing resources to run it. And so that's another part of the criteria. And you know, Crossplane is actually quite diverse from that standpoint today. More than half of the maintainers on Crossplane don't have outbound emails, which is a really, really great place to be. And that trend is going to increase as the project continues to grow.
What kind of roadmap is there for the project?
Crossplane is interesting in the sense that, it obviously touches a lot of different other projects and products from different vendors, right? So for a universal control plane to be truly universal, it needs to access infrastructure from, you know, across the entire spectrum of you know, vendors. And so a big part of our focus as a Crossplane community is to increase coverage of what, infrastructure and API that Crossplane can touch. And so that's a big focus for the community. And you'll see more and more work that's happening there, both in terms of, you know, implementing support for certain vendors, but also working with the community to make the to make it easier for them to contribute and make it easier for them to add support for Crossplane and working on tooling to support the ecosystem around this. So that's a big focus for the community. The developer experience around Crossplane and building a big feature that we have in the Crossplane project is a feature called Composition, which lets platform teams essentially build their own API endpoints that are, you know, have all the guardrails and policies and compliance and governance in place to let developers self-service on infrastructure, which if you follow what's happening around self-service and developer portals and shifting infrastructure to the left, that's a big focus for us in Crossplane. And you'll see more from the community around custom compositions and improving the features around composition and especially the developer experience around it.
Bassam, thank you so much for taking time out today and talk about Crossplane. What really these sandboxing incubation and aggression really mean? So thanks for sharing those insights. And I wish we could have done this in person, but hopefully things will settle down by next year and we will be doing these interviews again in person. Thanks for your time today.
Yeah, thank you so much. Always a pleasure to be here and looking forward to meeting again in person.